If the door is provided with a solid shaft, position the springs on the shafts with the black-coated right-hand drum on the right end of one shaft, the right shaft, and the red-coated left-hand drum on the left end of the other shaft, the left shaft. Position springs with black cones oriented to the right on the right shaft and springs with red cones oriented to the left on the left shaft. If four springs are provided for the door, both right-hand springs should be positioned on the same right shaft and both left-hand springs on the same left shaft. Position half of the solid shaft coupler on the opposite end of the shaft from the torsion drum. Set the coupler on the shaft using the 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch by 3 inch key and set screws. Set screws toward the spring so that the larger end of the coupler is flush with the end of the solid shaft. Repeat for the second solid shaft. The shafts can be raised into position independently. The end of the shaft with the drum should be inserted into the end bearing plate. The red drum must be on the left side looking out, the black on the right side looking out. Level the shaft at the center support plate and securely fasten the brackets to the center support mounting pad using red-headed fasteners. Adjust the spacing from the wall to the shaft to be the same as it is at the end bearing plate. Allow room on the center mounting pad for attaching the second center support plate from the other half shaft. The opposite side shaft should be mounted in place using the same technique. If there are four springs, ensure that the shaft is level and fastened to auxiliary spring mounting pads in a similar manner. The center coupler should be bolted tightly together using 3/8 inch by 2 inch bolts provided, making certain that the keyway on the two shafts are aligned. Be sure the shaft assembly is straight and level to avoid stresses caused by any misalignment. Starting on either side, adjust the torsion drum at the end bearing plate. Insert the 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch key and fasten the drum with the set screw. Set the drum firmly against the bearing. Wrap the cable as described previously for torsion tube installations, and then set the vice grip to hold the cable taut as described in the torsion tube installation. Wrap the cable onto the other drum as described in the torsion tube installation. When the cable is tight, insert the 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch key into the drum shaft slot and fasten the set screws. Ensure that all attachments and set screws are tight. Wind the springs as described in the previous